Ms. Yo Heun-hae, Deputy Prime Minister and Ministers of Education, Mr. Ban Ki-moon, former Secretary General of the United Nations, Mr. Nam Seok-ko, Mayor of Yeonsu, Excellencies, Ladies and Gentlemen, Annyeong Haseyo, good morning, good afternoon, everybody. I am delighted to welcome you all to the 5th International Conference on Learning Cities taking place in a hybrid format. Let me start by expressing my deep gratitude to the mayor of Yeonsu and his city for bringing us together in these challenging times. Your city has done outstanding work in promoting lifelong learning over the years, and we are grateful for your determination to host this conference. It's a pity I cannot be there, but it's a pleasure to connect with you today. And let me start to say that this is more than ever a time for collaboration around the transformative agenda for humanity and the planet as we slowly emerge from a health crisis that has actually disrupted every aspect of our lives with dramatic consequences and impact. If there is one lesson to draw from this crisis, it's that education and health are global public goods necessary today to be prioritized. And every city must understand ways of ensuring their universal provision. As the lead UN specialized agency for education, but also science, culture, and communication, as you know, UNESCO takes a holistic approach, a holistic vision of learning throughout life as a human right and as a foundation for all development. I know how this conviction is at the heart of the Republic of Korea's journey from a war-torn nation to a major player in advancing education worldwide. Our campus for recovery remains in the UN's 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development and its 17 interconnected goals, and I wish to recognize the leadership here of former Secretary General Ban Ki-moon as well as Mr. David Navarro, his former special advisor. Our collective progress towards inclusive, equitable, quality education and lifelong learning, actually the mission we have around SDG4, is under threat. We know very clearly. At the peak of the pandemic, 1.6 billion learners around the world in some 119 countries were affected by school closures and university closures. And close to one third of students couldn't access remote learning solutions. As such, inequalities everywhere have been magnified, exacerbated. And the urgency now is to address them head on and make education the lever of a sustainable and inclusive recovery. And this is what we are hardly working on. Through global evidence gathering, guidance, policy dialogue, and collaborative action with the UN partners, especially UNICEF, the World Bank, UNESCO has supported countries around the world in their efforts, huge efforts, to mitigate the impact of school closures, addressing learning losses, and adapt education systems to this new current environment, particularly for vulnerable and disadvantaged communities. In this context, UNESCO has established, as you maybe remember, the Global Education Coalition to mobilize and support learning continuity. Throughout the pandemic, the UNESCO Global Network of Learning Cities has served as a singular, unique platform for members to showcase their responses, to share their own experiences and best practices, and to learn each from each other. Furthermore, over the years, the network has brought together representatives to share their expertise through international conferences in many places, Beijing, Mexico City, Cork, Medellin. And regardless of their size, the 229 member cities of this network, impressive number, I would say, share the common goal of mobilizing the resources across all sectors to maximize opportunities for lifelong learning and achieve all the SDGs. Indeed, this conference aims to strengthen the linkages between the SDGs, especially those on education, health, gender equality, and cities. This year's conference will focus on how we can build healthy and resilient cities through learning. It's a simple mission, but it's very much impactful in the coming years. To be sustainable, cities need to devise alternative approaches to urban development, to rebuild our relationship to each other, the planet, and technology, actually to strengthen social cohesion and to expand opportunities to acquire skills needed for the green and digital transition, which are actually the two main big initiatives and projects that governments are running all over the world. Having said that, let me conclude to say that I strongly believe that together we can put forward comprehensive solutions that capitalize on cities' capacities for innovation. I trust that member cities will find this conference an inspiring source of knowledge sharing and good practices information, and I renew our appreciation to the cities of Yeosu and to the Republic of Korea for hosting this event and for their commitment to boost the program of learning cities of UNESCO. I wish you a very fruitful discussion. Kamsa Amida, I thank you very much.